Thank you. Call unto the Lion of the tribe of Judah. Better believe we have a lion. He will fight for us. Talk to the Lord. Heaven, hear your amen. The Lord bid me just now to tell that fellow that I've been weeping to wipe away the tears from the eyes. The reason is that God will take over your battle from this morning. He knows all your problems. The Lord will wipe away your tears. Agabi galam wine mema gabi galam onye win. Agabi galam wina gwori agabi galam chukomale. Agabi galam wine mudo agabi galam chukomale. Agabi galam mwine nyega, agabi galam chuku dema. Jehovah Nisi, mwine memale, mwina gwaria chimama, mwine nyegole, mwine nyema chimama. Let me hear your voices here. Don't lose hope. Hold on to the Lord. Daddy mama, chukune memale, mwine Kill away your sorrows. The lion of the tribe of Judah is here to fight for you. Hey! Come on, let me hear your voices. Take the mic, these people. Hold the mic. Come on, praise him. Hallelujah. Timothy mama. Take him not to pass you by. Sing it from your heart. Come on, let me hear you. Adioma, onu kwenyezele. Adioma, akane mempande. Akana baji mchukwama.
Abi gano,
tu gano, abi gano, tu 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 gano, tu
I'm gonna go get
Joyful noise unto the Lord. The Lord is doing a separation. Business has started. It is time for sacrifice. And all that left everything and came in here today, that is sacrifice. Every day prayers. But God gave me something special for you today. Go back, carry your Bible. If you like, you stand up. If you like, you sit down. Be open to receive. What is touching you is touching Jehovah. No frustration will work in your life. The Lord touches you to praise Him. Fear nothing and praise Him. I want to read. That your song, sing it again. Let me hear it. Hallelujah! The title of this morning Charismatic Hour says, How to Fight the Battle of the Time. Tell me the topic. Okay, everybody sit down. I read it. I begin to pray for you. Ephesians chapter 6. Are you there? Ephesians chapter 6 from verse 10. Finally, after I have said everything, now see the conclusion. Finally, my brethren, be strong in the Lord and in the power of His might. Put on the whole armor of God that ye may be able to stand against the wiles of the devil. For we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, against the rulers of the darkness of this world, against spiritual wickedness in high. We have for take unto you the whole armor of God, that ye may be able to do what? To withstand the evil day, and having done all, to stand. And he encourages us, he says, stand therefore. Sister, stand. Brother, stand. You don't seem to believe me. Sister, stand. Brother, stand. Brethren, stand. Stand therefore, having your loins girt about with truth, and having on the breastplate of righteousness, and so on. Listen, the one thing I would like you to know is that there is war. Is anybody listening to me? All of us in Nigeria will not say, I didn't know. But however, not everybody have the knowledge of war until they are taken captive. Majority of us are in the prison, in the custody of devil right now, unknowingly, because they were ignorant of the terrible war that started raging long ago. And so what happened? Now that we are knowing it, we must be ready to fight the war. One thing with war is that it instills fear. It comes with terrible pressure and fear. Once you tell somebody, do you know, this is going to happen, and they say they're going to fight, there will be terrible bloodshed. Even a man will begin to quake. Is it true? The person will say, instead of fighting, let's just leave it. Let's remain slaves. How long will you be a slave? The war I'm talking of today is not a physical warfare. It is what? But anything you see in the physical is already manifested in there. The spiritual controls the physical. And so those that fell here in the physical are not failing here. They have failed in the spiritual. And who can tell me the war between who and whom? If you know it, you raise up the one I'm talking of. What is our topic again? In the battle of the, which means there is a battle now. Tell me who and who are fighting. You are fighting me?
No.
Can you fight me?
No.
We are brethren. Who and who are fighting? If you know it, raise up your hand. Yeah, brother dear. Make it simple so that some of us that didn't go to Bible school will understand. Another person? Eh? Is the sister I'm asking? Satan and whom? No, is that sister there? What did you say before? Satan and what? And we. Yes. Don't fear. If you fail, we correct you. It is not a war between Satan and God. It cannot be. But listen, is there any way Satan can fight God?
No.
I mean, you call God and call Satan and say, fight. Like you bring mosquito now, and you bring trailer, caterpillar self carrying gongoro inside, and you say fight the mosquito. If he climbs the mosquito, will you ever see the mosquito again? So God cannot have time to begin to fight with what? Satan. The battle is between Satan and you. Why is he fighting you? If you go back to Genesis, you see when man was formed. God said, let us make man in our
image.
And that place that Satan lost, we are replacing him. We do well, live with God, we go to heaven. And he says, so people will go and take my position, that it will not be. I will fight them. And because he's fighting the image of God, God became interested. But he didn't say, go out of the way, let me finish devil. He said, you must fight. You must do what? And now he begins to tell us how to fight by Spirit of God through Apostle Paul. It brings the truth. It brings righteousness to guide your heart. It brings shoes of what? Of evangelism or preaching to the people this word of salvation. It shows us. That is for Bible study. But, you know, since it is a spiritual warfare, if you begin to fight physically, you have failed. Everybody sit up. I say, if you begin to fight what? Physically, you have failed. Most often in your house, in the church, in the business places, a lot of us have enemies. Two of us.
True.
But if you check what is happening between you and that person, you will discover with time, if you have patience, to undergo some questions and answers that the person didn't even know what is happening. He didn't know. It's just the same way you are seeing it, he's seeing it. Sometimes, as I did some studies in the Bible in the early days, the person that was teaching said, get back to those people that have offended you and ask them, what did I do you that you are treating me like this? And he said, if you do that, you will be surprised that the person will tell you, I don't know what you are saying. Say, me? Doing that? God forbid. Actually, the person is not lying. Anybody can be manipulated by Satan. Do you know? When he said it, I didn't go to ask. Because in secondary school, class 1, I used to remember things very well. I so much did punishments in class one that a person who knew my family very well wrote a letter and gave to me that they should come and withdraw me because I was going to fail in class one. And if I fail, it will bring disgrace to our family. The school will quit me. Punishments. If you see me free any day, you know they were playing football. They push me into the field. If not, I'll be going to somewhere to fetch water. As I'm returning, they give me hoe to go and dig pit. I don't know whether it was because I was too quiet. I can't tell. Do this, I will be slowly doing it. Say, go and bring your hoe. I will gently go to bring my hoe, go and dig pit. Every day I was digging pit. Every day I was fetching water. So one day, just from childhood, some things that is in you now, if you check it has been in you from childhood, something that will help you in ministry or that will destroy you. That's why you watch it. I went to the brother. I said, senior, what did I do to you? Every day you are punishing me. What did I do? Tell me what I did. He said, Mwegu. Me? I said, yes. Are you talking to me? I said, yes. Every day I can't go to class. He said, me punish you? I said, every day. He said, no, I can't do that. How can I punish you? Came close to put his hand on me. I said, okay, number one, on Wednesday, I dug pit. On Thursday, I dug pit. On Friday, I'm giving you an example. I went to fetch water, far, far place. Were you not the person sending me? And the man opened his mouth. He said, from today, I will never send you to do any punishment. Forgive me. I learned it from that class one. What we need to fight when we see those things is to do what? Go to the spiritual warfare. Open your Bible and read. Kneel down and pray. If you don't